So live a life you will remember. My father told me when I was just a child, these are the nights to never die. My father told me.
Hi, I'm Jonas, and welcome back to ATown Weekly. After over a year of recording from home, we're finally back in our studio at school. This week, we're going to take a look at the second segment of our Season of Genius series, and Malachi is going to get us caught up on sports. But first, here's John with a few important announcements.
Good morning, Patriots. I'm John. Today's Monday, March 22nd, and here's what's happening at ATown today. Did you know that PVCC offers training programs in nursing, accounting, cybersecurity, EMT paramedic services, early childhood education, graphic design, advanced manufacturing, and much more? Some programs can be completed in as little as one semester, offering shorter time commitments and specific skills for employment. Financial aid is available for eligible students. If you are interested in learning more about training programs offered at PVCC, join us on Friday, March 26th at 2 p.m. for an informational Zoom session. Email your counselor career specialist, Ms. McMahon at mcmahon@k12albemarle.org, or your PVC transition specialist, Ms. Ratliff at clratliff@k12albemarle.org for the registration link. Patriots, for the weekend, starting the weekend of March 20th until further notice, parking will not be available in the junior and senior parking lot. Motorcycle safety classes will be held on Saturdays and Sundays from 7:30 a.m. until 5 p.m. Any cars left in the lot will be towed at the owner's expense. This information is also posted at the parking lot entrance. From today to March 31st, the Habitat Youth Leadership Team is putting on a furniture drive to benefit the Seville Habitat Store. If you have any furniture laying around that you want to get rid of, this is a great cause to put it towards. Please drop your furniture off at the Habitat Store on Harris Street on Tuesdays and Wednesdays from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. If you have any questions, please refer to the poster or email Chris Woods at ckws9@k12albemarle.org. Last week, we met with Emily Chang, a participant in the Winter Season of Genius, a program that highlights what some of our classmates have been up to during quarantine. This week, I met with Abena, who has been busy organizing a literacy campaign. Here's a look at that interview.
I'm here with Abena, and Abena, what exactly did you do for your project?
So my project was a literacy campaign in Ghana, so I collected donated books from libraries, bookstores, nonprofits in the area. We have a lot of like niche little book places in Charlottesville, and I packaged them, and I'm in the process of shipping them to like schools, elementary through high schools in Ghana, so yeah.
That sounds amazing. Do you have like any family like relation to Ghana?
Yeah, so my parents are immigrants, and I lived in Ghana for a time. We eat the food at home, we speak the language, so being Ghanaian is a big part of my identity. It's like a thing of pride for me. Yeah,
that's great.
I wanted to give back.
That's just great, being able to give back to your own community where you came from. But what exactly like inspired you to want to give back? Just the culture or what?
So as you know, quarantine has been a time of a lot of growth for a lot of people. It's been stressful. There've been like the good and the bad, but for me, it's been a lot of growth and a lot of maturing. So I realized that looking back, before like the pandemic and everything, it felt like I was doing all the right things, but I was going through the motions. And I realized that I wanted to make an actual change and do something good that would help others. And I love like creating little events and tasks and accomplishment. And so this is just where I loved it. Like all the emails, all the calling, the stores, the back and forth runs, the spreadsheets for the book drives. Like I love all of that stuff. I mean, it's tedious for some, but I really enjoy that kind of thing. So the organization aspect of it, I enjoy that. And then obviously I'm getting to help schools and communities, and yeah.
I can see where you're coming from. It always feels good to be able to know, hey, I organized all this. I was able to get it done, and I'm doing it for a great cause.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for your interview.
Yeah, that was so easy. Yeah. Oh my gosh, John, I was freaking out. Okay, that wasn't as bad.
Well, thank you.
Thank you.
Have a great day.
Have a great day. Bye, John.
The AHS Lanterns Literary Art Magazine received their competition results from the Southern Interscholastic Press Association's 2021 conference. For the first time ever, the AHS Lantern has won the esteemed Scroggins Award for Best Literary Art Magazine of the South for 2020 Ambrosia Edition. Congratulations to the LitMag staffs, past and present, for making the Scroggins Award a reality, even through a pandemic, and designing a LitMag virtually. The National English Honor Society will be holding its next meeting on this Friday, March 26th at 11:30 a.m. We'll be discussing spring service, opportunities, senior cords, and next year's membership. Members, please check your email for the Zoom link from Mr. Panarese. If you have any questions, please contact Mr. Panarese or Alicia Fan. Now over to Malachi with sports.
Hey Patriots, let's get you caught up with all the winter sports so far this season. The field hockey team is 3-0 to start the season. Seniors Caroline Jones and Liz Yao have been on fire of late with some assistance from sophomore Caroline Hewlett and junior Maggie Lynn. Also, interesting fact, senior goalie Georgia Costain hasn't allowed an opposing goal all season long. On Tuesday night we face Louisa and Wednesday night we play Monticello. Tune into the ATown Today YouTube channel to catch the stream. The varsity football team so far this season is 2-2. Ebenezer McCarthy has had a fantastic season so far this year with 3 rushing touchdowns. The team looks to bounce back from a devastating 36-0 loss at the hands of Western on Friday night when we take on Charlottesville at home. We'll be streaming the game on the ATown Today YouTube channel. Tune in. The volleyball team kicked off its seasons after COVID rescheduling on Monday night at home against Orange. It was senior night for the Patriots, so the team put on a show. Kira Roach had 34 assists, 7 kills, and 5 aces, and junior Maya Winterhoff had 14 kills and 2 blocks. The team also played at Fluvanna on Thursday night and won 3-0. The team takes on Fluvanna tonight, Louisa tomorrow, and Western on Wednesday at home. JV starts at 5:30 and varsity starts at 7. We'll be streaming the games, but it won't be on the ATown Today YouTube channel. It'll be streamed on the Albemarle Athletics YouTube account. If for some reason you can't find the stream from the YouTube channel, the link for the game will be tweeted out on the ATown Today Twitter account and will be in the bio of the ATown Today Instagram account. So far, the leader in the Malachi's ATown Today bracket group is Ryan Castro. Congrats. Make sure to make your bracket first and last name so we know who wins. We can keep track. Keep up to win spectacular prizes. Congrats to Josh Morse on the boys basketball team who earned second team All-State honors from VHCSA. Make sure to tune in and stay up to date with all the Albemarle sports on the ATown Today Instagram and Twitter accounts. Now over to Jonas.
Thanks for tuning in to ATown Weekly. Remember to send your important announcements to wpat@k12albemarle.org. That's all for now. Have a great week and we'll see you next Monday.